We continue our reading of From the Heart, a daily devotional by author Ellen G. White. Today's reading, November 17, Channels for the Son of Righteousness. Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ, 2 Corinthians 5:20. The professed church of God may be possessed of wealth, education, and knowledge of doctrine, and may say by her attitude, I am rich and increased with goods and have need of nothing. But if its members are devoid of inward holiness, they cannot be the light of the world. The church is to reflect light into the moral darkness of the world, as the stars reflect light into the darkness of the night. These who have a form of godliness but deny the power thereof do not reflect light into the world and will not have power to reach the hearts of the unsaved. Without vital connection with Christ, the value of truth cannot be made to appear in good fruit in the world. But if Christ is formed within the hope of glory, His saving grace will be manifested in sympathy and love for perishing souls. Every soul truly converted to God will be a light in the world, bright, clear rays from the Sun of Righteousness, will shine forth through human agents who use their entrusted ability to do good, for they will cooperate with heavenly agencies and labor with Christ for the conversion of souls. They will diffuse the light which Christ sheds upon them. The Sun of Righteousness, shining in their hearts, will shine forth, enlightening and blessing others. The rays of heaven shining from human agents will exert a subduing influence upon those whom Christ is drawing to Himself. The church is weak before the angels of heaven unless power is revealed through its members for the conversion of those who are perishing. Unless the church is the light of the world, it is darkness. But of the true followers of Christ it is written, we are laborers together with God. Ye are God's husbandry, ye are God's building. The church may be composed of those who are poor and uneducated, but if they have learned of Christ the science of prayer, the church will have power to move the arm of omnipotence. The true people of God will have an influence that will tell upon hearts. It is not the wealth or the education of ability which the members of the church may possess that constitutes their efficiency. It is when the Sun of Righteousness shines forth from the people of God that Christ is glorified and His kingdom advanced. It is then that they are chosen vessels of salvation and are fitted for the Master's use. Signs of the Times, September 11, 1893. This concludes our reading today of From the Heart. Sweet Hour of Prayer.
Sweet Hour of Prayer, Sweet Hour of Prayer. While resting one day by the side of the road, I saw an old farmer in a field he just hoed. His face was all browned and wrinkled by the wind. and he is talking to the Lord just like he'd be talking to a friend. He said, "Well, sir," in a voice calm and quiet, "them corn tassels needs a sacking, but I got no string to tie. Ain't had no rain in so long, the fields is mighty dusty, and it's been so unbearable hot, even the kids is getting fussy. And you take the grass in that pasture, Lord, why it ought to have been knee high. We could just get a shire or two. Might keep the cow from going dry. But listen to me a talking. Why, you'd think that I wasn't grateful. And if you didn't know me so well, Lord, you'd think I was downright hateful. You'd think I wasn't thankful for the new calf that you sent and the money that came in the mail to catch up the rent. Why, Ma's coal's better and Johnny's home from the Navy. And that Sunday dinner with chicken, dumplings, and gravy. And the new preacher you sent us, Lord, he sure is a fine young man. Why, he's been converting them sinners just to beat the band. Well, I guess I'll be moseying along, Lord, and not take up no more of your time. I guess a heap of folks hereabouts is waiting to ring your line. Evening to you, Lord, and watch over us tonight. And don't go worrying about us none, because everything's gonna be all right. I've anchored my soul in the heaven of rest. I'll sail to what I see. Everybody sing it. I've anchored my soul in heaven's rest.
I've anchored my soul in the haven of rest. I've sailed the wide seas no more.
But with